Welcome to this Draw My Life About Jigsaw. If you have a despicable life, if you don't earn money in a fair way, or if you're a bad person that takes life for granted or you don't appreciate it, you shouldn't be surprised if one day you wake up tied up in a room next to a television where you can see a puppet that makes you choose between cutting your own leg or dying in the room. These kind of tests are typically symbolic to Jigsaw, also known as Jigsaw the Killer. However, before taking his victims to the limit, behind that cold face there's a normal person, a man called John Kramer. He was a successful civil engineer. His wife and him opened a recovery clinic under the motto, "Cherish your life." But what happened to him? First of all, his unborn child died when a patient of the clinic tried to rob her. Later, a disagreeable doctor diagnosed him with a colon cancer and a frontal lobe tumor that were no longer treatable. Also, his requests to do an experimental therapy were repeatedly declined by his insurance company. Utterly depressed, John tried to end his life by driving his car off a cliff. However, he survived the crash. Severely injured, he pulled the jagged piece of metal out of his body, and that's when he turned into Jigsaw. He decides to spend his remaining time testing other people's will to live, in order to convince them to value their life in extreme situations. Let the games begin. Paul was one of his victims. He was an alcoholic that attempted to commit suicide by cutting his wrist. Jigsaw took Paul to a basement full of tightened skeins of razor wire. If he wanted to live, he had to find a way to the door within the next 3 hours. At the end, he dies due to the massive loss of blood. Amanda is a drug addict. John locked her in a room, and when she woke up, she found herself to be strapped into a chair and had a metallic device full of spikes placed on her head. If she wanted to live, she had to search the only key in the stomach of a dead cellmate. Amanda managed to get free moments before the trap was activated and she became Jigsaw's apprentice. Then they began to plan their next game, that we can watch in the movie called Saw. Adam is a photographer that wakes up in a tub. He's shackled to a pipe. There's a corpse and a recorder next to him, and he sees Dr. Gordon chained to a metal pipe on the opposite corner of the room. Remember that name. They are in an underground bathroom, and if they want to live, they have to cut their arms and legs with a saw and kill each other. The corpse on the floor is Jigsaw pretending to be dead. The next game is a little bit different. Jigsaw wants Detective Matthews to learn the lesson. He locks Matthews' son in a room with people once framed by the detective for crimes they didn't commit. They all have to find the way to survive in a house full of traps if they don't want to be killed by a deadly nerve agent. Matthews just has to wait and be patient. However, he loses the game. When Jigsaw is about to die, he decides to play a final game. Dr. Lin had to keep John alive operating on him, until another victim managed to finish a series of tests. She manages to do so. Amanda was very jealous, so she pulled her gun and she shot Lin in her back. Everyone dies in the movie. Amanda, Lin, and even John. Show must go on, and Saw the Fourth shows some very funny games. Two men wake up in a room, one of them has his eyes sewn shut, and the other one has his mouth shut. There was a machine and a chain that was on both ends attached to two shackles around their necks. If they pulled strong enough, they would be strangled. The one who killed the other first would be freed. Jigsaw's legacy is very large, and even if he's already dead, he left several recordings to his apprentices and they're in charge to keep playing his games. In the movie Saw the Fifth, Seth Baxter wakes up shackled to a table. If he wants to live, he has to put his hands into two vices and push the buttons behind them. This would activate the vices and crush his hands. Life is a matter of choices. In the movie Saw the Sixth, we can see the masterpiece Kramer has created. Simon and Eddie were two moneylenders who plunged people into debt, giving them large amounts of credit they couldn't pay back. When they wake up, they have 60 seconds to cut off their own flesh and toss it in the large scale in the middle of the room. Whoever managed to sacrifice the most flesh would survive, while the other one would be killed by the metal device on her head. Simone cuts off her left arm and wins. We talked about Lawrence Gordon before. After surviving the Jigsaw's test, he agreed to become his accomplice. One of his tests was to abduct a group of racist skinheads and put them in a car. One of them had his back glued to the driver's seat, another one was tied to the back of the car, a woman was tied up under the car, and the last one was tied to the garage door by his jaw. We can already tell you that they don't win the game. Jigsaw has a morally acceptable objective. He just wants his victims to appreciate life. The problem is that he goes too far. Don't forget to live your life and love everyone that surrounds you. Or don't be surprised if Billy the Puppet visits you. If you like this Draw My Life about Jigsaw, give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Tell us in the comment section down below what you would like to watch next time. See you on the next video.